Hello everyone, welcome to this channel. I am Lilly and in this video I'm going to explain in depth the 1010 release patch notes plus a lot of the work the devs have done that is not in these notes. We have in total got more than 80 patches on the developer server since the last release with close to 400 points that needed to be tested. Without any further ado, let's get this show on the road. The biggest effort since the last patch is the further optimizations, giving us a better gameplay, better sound, better visuals and animations. Pathways, rivers, the ocean, all plants, animals and basically all entities have been reworked and improved. Humans as well have been optimized for a much smoother and efficient gameplay, all this to improve the playability. The devs have also optimized the game to a point where they hope all players can enjoy the game with no less than 30 frames, even in the larger tribes of 300 plus population. Shader compilations are greatly improved, the mesh resolution is improved for every graphic settings, terrain is improved, colors and textures are strengthened and streamlined, level of detail for flora and fauna is massively improved, even the clouds have got a revamp. And now let's move on to some of the community requests. First up, the peltards. They now need less stone to be built, and because of this, it will be quicker to build them up once your tribe has landed. There is more from the community, namely the mod integration, interface and output logs. So now you modders out there can get to work. If you need more help, you can always ask on Discord in the modding channel or in any of the dedicated modder forums. And more requests from the community. We now have builder groups. This means we no longer need to use our gathering or crafter groups to do all the building, and this is a very welcomed addition to the game. The developers are listening to the players, and we now have also got granted more straw from threshing wheat crops. This to help with both keeping livestock well fed and our housing repairs up to date. Livestock now also gives a lot more milk, but they do eat more. However, to help us out with feeding the animals, both wheat and flax grains now has more than double the calorie count per grain, meaning animals can live off the flax grains without us needing a lot of extra straw to feed them. Developers also added a lot more meat from animals and more pelts. And also, if that was not enough, the developers have also increased the brood per species of livestock. They now very often have both 2 and 3 offspring at the same time. But there is more. To also help us out with getting straw in large amounts from threshing, we can now add 6 sheaves of crop per round of threshing. This is a tripling of what we used to have before. Happy threshing! The community also asked for reed and straw needs for objects to be lowered, and developers complied. We now have less reed and straw need for most our housing, including the storehouse. And the devs went even further and gave us a higher production of both straw from tall grass and reed from both the riverside and from tall grass. Yet more community requested changes is the new system for sharing your tribe to others. Tribe sharing can now be done by changing the setting to on in your game options. You will now be able to go to the Ancient Cities website and see who else is playing the same time as you. The info will show where they are in Europe, what timeline they are playing, what culture they are, the name of their tribes, difficulty and their population. The information is of course dynamic and will change every minute or so. To me, this feels very much like step one to a multiplayer option. And guess what else? We can use the tribe names to communicate with each other as we play. Simply change the tribe name to whatever you wish to say to whomever else is playing. More player requests have been granted. This time it is the rosehip and the mushroom amounts. The devs have increased this all over Europe, and we can now again have a grand starter feast in both England as well as Spain. Previously, most of England did not even have a single rosehip bush until several years had passed. We have more requests from the community, this time with the amount of food that the wild animals are eating. They used to eat everything they could find. Now the amount of food eaten by wild animals have been reduced by 75%. So now we need not worry that the wild animals shall eat up all the wild produce. Next up is the fencing that many players are struggling to get secured. Devs have reworked the system and it is now more secure. You will, however, notice that you need to change how you normally do things when you wish to have a small diameter round fencing. On to the next community wish. Farm groups can now take 42 members and gathering groups can take 28. This will help anyone playing large tribes to make sure all needs are covered for the tribe size. As well as increased work spot, we have also been given help to see how many workers a farm can take. And to top that off, their farm size has also been increased from 210 cells to 300. We will definitely be needing all the 42 spots. We also have an increase in the migrant group frequency and also the livestock probability coming with them. In addition, livestock will need to be fed all year round, but they will only eat half of the normal amounts when the no grazing sign is not showing in tribe state. The no grazing can happen when the temperatures are too low or too high for the grass that livestock will eat to grow. But with all the help we have received in this patch, feeding should not be an issue. However, we as players must make sure we do not get so many animals that they are basically eating us out of the locality. All livestock coming with migrants will now move directly to the camp, even if they're not needing to feed. They will basically follow their herders. Humans' ability to wade in deep water has been increased. This basically means that the tribe will have less weird routes when wanting to go over the river to gather resources. They will instead pick a much more direct route. Farms have also received a very realistic change. When the land is not worked on, nature will do its best to take it over. And when farmers want to start tilling the land, they will first have to clear the farm of weed, grass and other plants that has grown since harvest time. To help with this, devs have made farmers quicker in their work and also increased the carry allocation for grass to 6. So the time spent on clearing is not taking the entire day. Another change asked for by the player community is the completion of tasks even when work hours are over. We have all been there. Gatherers reach the rosehip bushes by the edge of map just as resting time ticks in, and they turn around empty-handed 2 feet away from the resources. The developers have now implemented that further away tasks are not prioritized when it is close to resting time. But to make sure time is not wasted, they have also added overtime for these occasions. So people will, if possible, complete their tasks before stopping their work. Be aware though, there is a price to pay for this. Unrest can and will grow for those that work overtime. The longer they work overtime, the more unrest they will get. This tends to play out okay though, but some people will start to complain fairly quickly. They will, however, not leave due to this unrest alone, but will need a combination before they consider leaving the tribe. On to the next point. When tribe is hungry to a point of starvation, they will not wait for mealtime to tick in. They will instead go help themselves and then go back to work unless they are too sick. We can by this save more people if food is coming in too small amounts for all to eat at the same time. In addition, the queuing for food is made much more streamlined, so we will no longer see half the tribe queue in front of the same storage facility. They will instead divide themselves on all the storages that has their favorite food first. And if the queue is full, they will move on to the next storage and to the next and to the next and then finally to the next favorite food. So if you see people are eating grains or bones, you know you need more food or more storage options for all to not waste any time in queues. Another really nice implementation is the ability we now have to lock down bones in the storage areas where only the crafters can help themselves from the area. This will avoid unrest from people who eat the bones, and that is not all. Both lumberjacks and fishermen now have limits that player can put to their production. The blue icon next to the limit means that the player set limits has been met. On to the next. The threat to leave notifications are removed, and we will instead get warnings in the form of angry faces on members. You will not see the blue faces though, as those are very low unrest. But the yellow and certainly red will show. It is easier to pay attention to any unrest with this system rather than having no clue what's going on until they are threatening to leave. So pay attention to your people for any changes in their unrest. Red now is basically threatening to leave. And next, mask adherence has been made a lot stronger. This to avoid any jumping back and forth in groups and for tasks further away to still get done if time allows it. In addition, the priority for groups is now extremely strong. And based on the policies for communal tasks, you will see people doing much more sharply, either more group tasks pertaining to their group or more communal tasks if moving slider to the right. Be aware though that any long-term policy to the right or to the left will cause neglect for the tasks that are not prioritized. Recommendation is still to keep communal tasks on default and change it only in needed circumstances and events. Play around with the policies and you will quickly see how obedient your tribe now is. Moving on, hunters now team up several at a time depending on size of prey. The larger the prey, the bigger the hunting party. On to the next point, pine and hazel trees will now only be chopped down by lumberjacks if no other tree types are available. Choppers will first take all the unproductive and dead trees, then large trees and so on. This means that we as players need to pay attention to this whenever we are in any area close to the Mediterranean Ocean when there are few other tree types available. Next point, base priority of tasks has been improved. You will find that some tasks automatically have higher priority than others. As usual, building and repairs, when communal tasks are on default, will always have the highest priority. But farm work and burials are following close after. Next point, humans have had their lives prolonged, so now your favorite people will live longer and learn more. At the same time, the younger generation will have longer time to learn from the elders, which of course means you are less likely to lose levels of knowledge. Remember, we as players must still create the tasks needed for the younger generation to learn. The eating habits are also adjusted a bit. People will eat when they wake up, unless the queues are too long. Then they will instead go to work until the queues are gone or until they come back to camp to load off their resources. The evenings are also made longer to avoid a lot of stress, and also the amount of time they spend eating is drastically reduced. All this to make tribe much more efficient with a lot less time wasted. Next point up, when migrating, the straw tribe has will come with to avoid your livestock starving. So no, it is not a bug or an error, it is working as intended. Next up is the change in autosave intervals. We already have the option of choosing between 1 hour, 30 minutes, 15 minutes And now we have also got the option to choose 5 minutes, so find out whatever suits you the most. There are of course some bug fixes, but the utter majority of them are nipped in the bud during testing. There is however one that got through onto the public servers. This was the limit of items still counting after traders had made their way to the target with the goods. This has been fixed and limits are again now only counting whatever is in camp and not what the traders have run off with. On to the next point, we now also have changes in human behavior when a relative dies. The relatives of the newly deceased will gather close to the dead relative before he or she is buried. After the burial, we will also find that these relatives will, with regular intervals, go mourn and remember their relatives by their graves. So make sure you have the graveyard beautifully planned out with benches and lights for the relatives seeking the peace by their loved one's grave. Moving on, tribe sizes has been reduced in an effort to avoid explosive population without removing the option to reject or accept migrants or lowering birth rates so much that half a tribe dies out. We still have 7 for 10k BC, but for default Mesolithic timeline, 7k BC, we now have 10 starting members, where we previously had 14. For default Neolithic timeline, 4 to 50 BC, you will find we now have 14, where we used to have 21. And 1500 BC now has the max amount of members with 21. Next on the list, our feeders and production buildings now have resource lack report. This will inform us when we lack resources for the service or production to continue. This will surely help us to keep up with everything going on in the tribe. The last community request I will talk about in this video is the pause option in the game. We can now also use the space bar as well as the letter P to pause the game. And last on my very long list of points that I wanted to add to this video are the changes to the materials needed to build some of the fence types. Both the normal fence, the small fence, and also palisades will now also need rope to be completed. This also goes for both types of gates. And note also that since rope is the last resource added, it means this will be the resource needed for any maintenance and repairs. So ready your rope industry and prepare for massive usage when you are building a gazillion fence section around all your farms. Do not worry too much though, as the ropes takes a lot longer to need repairs than the sticks for normal and small fences. They now last 27 months before they need repairs. That's all the points I wanted the community to know. There are of course plenty more, but most are very technical and belonging to optimizations, improvements and tweaks in general for better gameplay. The devs are now immersed in new content and some are already in testing for next release. So hang tight, more is coming. Until then, have fun and take care.